So what if I took this and did this? Interesting. And here it is, DJI Action 2 dual screen combo comes in this nicely designed box. Inside the box we're greeted with a magnetic ball joint adapter mount, reusable sticky base, USB cable, magnetic lanyard, magnetic adapter for GoPro mounts, Action 2 and its front touchscreen module. Action 2 has 12-megapixel 1/1.7-inch CMOS sensor, 10mm f2.5 lens with 155 degrees field of view, and it can shoot up to 4K 120 frames per second video with sound in H.264 and H.265. The touch screens are 1.76-inch and they have 500 nits brightness. There is also another combo called DJI Action 2 Power Combo, which comes with a battery module instead of the front touchscreen. And even if I snap it into two, it still works. It can shoot videos up to 4K 120 frames per second. It has a giant OLED touchscreen where you can control it easily. It still can connect to your phone via Wi-Fi or Bluetooth and still gives live feedback to your phone. Has 22.4 GB internal storage. Actually, normally 32 GB of internal storage, but after the system, you get 22.4 GB. It has a 580 mAh 2.23 watt-hour battery inside this tiny thing, and DJI says it can shoot 1080 60 frames per second videos for 70 minutes. In my tests, I was able to shoot 4K 24 frames per second video with the screen brightness set up to 100% for 51 minutes and 7 seconds. Has a mono microphone and it is waterproof up to 10 meters. It is made from aluminum alloy and this material helps with the heat dissipation, which by the way, we're gonna be talking about it in this video. It also weighs 56 grams. Okay, this is 4K 120 frames per second. This thing is on a selfie stick. This is the audio test. So a little wind test. I don't know if it's recording audio in 4K. Oh yeah, it does record audio in 4K 120. I'm waiting for those guys to go away from that little area so I can one wheel on it, and I think they're leaving. All right, I think it's a go. They're doing a photo shoot over there. Overall, so far my experience has been really good. I just don't know what the footage looks like, but as far as I can see on the screen, it looks really good. A couple of things, I can hear it beep quite a lot. So when something happens, if we run out of space on the main module, or in my case, one of the memory cards I brought wasn't fast enough for 4K 120. When that happened, when it beeped saying like, I cannot record anymore, it was easy to hear. 4K 120 and 4K 100, I cannot see the screen that is facing me. It just turns off and it just says we're recording in 4K 120 or 100, whatever the frame rate you have set. The touchscreen is very simple to operate and the menu is very easy to understand. It's actually the same menu that we had on Osmo Action or other DJI products When you swipe from top to down, you go into this menu, and here you can change how you want to see the picture. Full screen off or on, I actually like full screen. And then you can lock the screen, you can look at the storage or SD card, which is in this, and we're going to talk about that later. And you can format them, and then we have settings where you can turn on voice control and stuff like that. Also on this side, we have the pro settings, voice control, orientation lock, and screen brightness. And when you swipe from left to right, you go into your gallery, and here we're seeing the internal storage and what I recorded the last. This is a hyperlapse. And when you swipe from right to left, you see your exposure, white balance, field of view, and the format. And when you swipe from bottom up, you change your settings. But also on the screen, when you swipe right in the middle of the screen, you can quickly switch between the modes. It is really good. Nicely done. And when you tap on the battery, you see how much battery you have left. And here we have the digital zoom, which we're going to talk about it later. The Rocksteady on this one is a lot less severe compared to Osmo Action. Osmo Action was very bad. There was a big crop, and in return you were getting a crazy stabilized footage. But this just puts in 11% crop, and the footage doesn't get affected that much. But there's also another feature called Horizon Steady, and you can do that in 1080p. So let's switch to 1080p and see how it levels the horizon no matter what you do with the camera, no matter how you turn it. There it is, this is Horizon Steady, and it adds in a crop, but no matter what I do, the footage must be leveled out nicely. I don't know, we're gonna see it together. There's also digital zoom. Right now we're at 1x. Let's say we're shooting this and we wanna get close up. Boom, 4x digital zoom. Now, as you can see, there is no tripod mount or a GoPro mount on this. This thing is magnetized and has a different mount system. So you're gonna need stuff like these, and these actually just snaps into the mount, and it is pretty strongly attached there. And then if you want to take it off, you just push these clips out, and then that's how you take it out, and then it just snaps back in. It's pretty good. I drove around while this was mounted to my car, and it didn't fall off. And the great thing is the connection from Action 2 module was strong enough to give me a live feedback while I was in the car. Wow, we can see it from here. With the same system, the front-facing touchscreen module just snaps in, and now we have an action camera that actually looks more like the Osmo Action, but the difference is this is usually mounted this way. You can mount it this way as well, but it is usually built to be mounted like this. The front touchscreen module has 1300 milliampere hour, 5 watt hour battery in it. It has 1, 2, and 3 microphones. So in total, you're getting 4 microphones when this is combined. We also have a speaker here, which is pretty strong, and it actually sounds really good. And it has a memory card slot, a USB-C connection, same mount here on the sides, a shutter button, and of course the front facing touchscreen. But the thing is, this module is not waterproof, so if you want to use it like this and take advantage of the extra battery life this delivers to this combination, you're gonna need the waterproof case. So when it's combined, it weighs 121 grams, which is still lighter than Osmo Action. Now you may be thinking, something this small, 4 centimeter to 4 centimeter square thingy that can shoot 4K 120 frames per second, what's the situation with overheating? Well, I'm glad you asked, because overheating is inevitable when a product is this small and it can shoot in 4K 120 frames per second. In my tests, I was able to shoot 5 minutes and 30 seconds just with the base, and the battery drained from 100% to 76%, and this thing heated up to 51 degrees Celsius, which is really hot. The living room was 25 degrees Celsius. I recorded in HEVC, and yeah, it overheated in 5 minutes. With the base, I was able to record for 6 minutes and 50 seconds, and the battery went from 100% to 84% on the base, and it heated up to 53.3 degrees Celsius, and the living room was the same temperature. I kept everything the same. So yeah, so this thing heats up a lot, but also there's a setting here, temperature setting, and it is set to high. I think you should leave it at standard if you're gonna shoot indoors, and you should never let this heat up that much. It gets really hot. I have never seen a product that gets this hot, so watch out for that. But when you're outside, when there's wind, when this thing can cool down, because it cools down quite efficiently when there's a breeze or something because of its material, then there's no problem. For example, today when I was outside in Venice Beach under the sun, well, it was kind of a cold day, but it didn't heat up at all. There I got zero heat warnings, and I shoot in 4K 120 frames per second, and I kept the camera on all the time, and I changed the battery. I used it all day long, and I didn't even see the heat warning once, and it was never too hot to touch, but it was hot at some times. And because this is magnetic, I can just snap this anywhere and use it this way as well. It's not super strong. You probably don't want to, you know, snap this on your car and drive around, but it is pretty strong. You can just use it to have like an overhead shot. It will work. It will hang in there. We have hyperlapse, time lapse, slow motion, video, quick clip, photo, and live stream modes. I haven't been excited about an action camera for a really long time, and as soon as I saw this, I was really excited, because this is kind of a game changer. I thought when you disconnect this main module from the front-facing touchscreen battery module, this was gonna lose most of its features, but apart from the speaker and the battery life and of course a little bit of storage, this can still shoot in 4K 120 frames per second. It is pretty impressive what's happening. And if you know its limitations, and if you adjust yourself to its limitations, I think you're gonna have a great time. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode, and I hope you enjoyed it. As usual, I'm really curious about what you think of Action 2. Is this something you're interested in? Is this something you'll be picking up? What do you think about this mounting option instead of, you know, something like this? Do you think this is gonna work? I think for some scenarios this will work better, but for some scenarios it may not work better. So I think DJI should release something so we can mount it sideways like this. Yeah, let me know in the comment section below. And until I see you the next time, take really good care of yourselves, and hoşça kalın.